Welcome to the PLC course. Before starting to learn about PLC, I want to discuss a little bit about automation. These days, many industries are automated. Their whole process is working automatically with minimum human intervention. And in the days to come, it will become more and more developed. Just see a Pepsi factory as an example. From preparing compound or liquid to filling it in bottles and packing, every stage is automated. No need for humans to measure the quantity of liquid, capping and label the bottles, and count the bottles. All tasks are done automatically. But how is it possible? Everything we will know in this course. Let's start. First of all, what is automation? The word automation. Auto means self, motive means action or process of moving. So automation means self-processing, taking any action without human intervention directly. We can define automation in these words. Automation is the creation and application of technologies to produce and deliver goods and services with minimal human intervention. The implementation of automation technologies, techniques, and processes improve the efficiency, reliability, and speed of many tasks that were previously performed by humans. There are many types of automation. Even in the home, we can see automation processes in many machines, like microwave oven, washing machines, air conditioners, and many more. Automation can be classified in home automation, scientific automation, robotic automation, and many more. Industrial automation is also one of them. The automation introduced in the industry is called industrial automation. In other words, if we use devices in the industry to complete manufacturing tasks or processes automatically, it will be called industrial automation. So, why do we use automation in industry? Let's compare manual control and automatic control or automation. Just look at a boiler's operation manual control. It has a temperature gauge and a handle valve to control fuel. A human must be there to look at the temperature gauge and control the handle valve. He will close the valve upon the temperature reached the required value. So think about the risks. Only a human is responsible for the whole action. The temperature can't be accurate. There are chances of human error. Can't handle if we need to control a large number of valves. Human is there at a boiler that is not safe. The life of humans is at risk. Now see automatic control. The temperature gauge is replaced with a temperature transducer. The handle valve is replaced with a control valve, and the human is replaced with a temperature controller. Yes, human is replaced with temperature controllers. And they all are connected through wire and power supply. The required temperature is already set at temperature controller, that is called SV means set value, and temperature transducer send a signal of current temperature, it's called PV means processing value. When PV reaches the SV value, a signal will transmit to the control valve, and the valve will be closed automatically. So, the same action has been done without humans. So human is in a safe place. No chance of errors, the temperature will be accurate. Can handle a large number of valves and actions. There are two basic types of automation systems. 1. Fixed automation system. 2. Programmable automation system. Fixed automation system. Fixed automation, also known as hard automation, refers to an automated production facility in which the sequence of processing operations is fixed by the equipment configuration. We use relays, timers, counters, and thermostats and pressure switches to perform the automated operation or manufacturing process. This automation system. Reduced human labor required. Consistency in quality. Fewer risks of human error. Improved health and safety. Improved efficiency. But this system takes huge space for installation. The biggest disadvantage of this system is it is fixed. If we need some changes in processes, sequence, it is impossible. To make a minor change, we have to change the hardware. That will be more expensive and time-taking. The other disadvantage is, this system has a large number of hardware and wires. So, fault finding is very hard, and a small fault can take more time to find the issue and resolve. 2. Programmable automation system. In this system, we use hardware that is programmable, the process is completed according to the preset program. And the whole process can be customized just by modifying the program if needed. Programmable logic controllers, PLCs, and programmable automation controllers, PACs, are the most efficient industrial computer devices that have been developed and designed to facilitate and assist in manufacturing tasks. This system is too fast, easy to change logic, i.e. flexibility, reliable due to absence of moving parts, low power consumption, easy maintenance due to modular assembly. Fault detection and diagnosis are very fast. Able to handle very complex logical operations. I hope you have learned about industrial automation very well. And also know a little bit about PLC. So in the next video, we will start learning about PLC. Thanks for watching. If you have not subscribed to my YouTube channel, please subscribe to it and press the bell icon to get notifications of new videos. If the video is helpful for you, like it and share it also. Goodbye.